What is going on, everybody? It is Man of Justice 21 here, bringing you another audio commentary. And today, the audio commentary is going to be focusing on Kingsglaive, Final Fantasy 15. Now, I haven't seen this movie yet at all. So, besides the 30 seconds I saw in Final Fantasy 15, the game, I'm pretty much going into this movie completely blind. And, well, one of you guys actually asked on one of my audio commentaries if I'm ever going to watch something or do an audio commentary on something I've never seen before. So here you go. Now, I don't own the movie, and I didn't rent the movie. I actually was lucky enough to find the movie, like the full movie, online. And if you guys want, you know, I'll put the link down below to where I watched it. So, as per usual, if you guys want to watch it with me, I am currently at the 0 second mark. So, on the count of three, two, one, go. Now, the reason why I didn't go out and buy it is because I don't really have the money to go out and buy it, but I really wanted to watch the movie. And usually you can find the full movie of anything pretty much online. That must be the crystal they've been talking about. Also, I'm laying on my bed, so you will hear squeaking. And there he is, Arden. You know, I did watch a video. No, I didn't watch a video. I watched. Was it a video? Either way, it was a video or an article based pretty much talking about Easter eggs in Final Fantasy 15. No, there's Noctis. And looks like, I'm guessing that's Luna, but she looks kind of weird. Even though I know she's young. But no, they mentioned something that I kind of took notice of, and it's how Niflheim is, I guess, an Easter egg because it sounds very similar to Niflheim from Final Fantasy VII. Hoo-hoo. I wonder why Noctis is in a wheelchair. Damn, that's a douche move. Like, he's more worried about Noctis than saving everyone else, too. Wait. I wonder if that was the last time. I think that was the last time Luna and Noctis saw each other. Must be a Trump wall. I'm kidding. Oh, that's cool. Oh, I wish. I wonder if you can. No, I don't think you can use a shield in the game. If you can, I should look that up. That'd be pretty useful. Man, this makes me wish Final Fantasy was a little bit more, well, not a little bit more, higher rated, rated M. There's the Imperials. What the hell are they dragging? Demon. I'm guessing it's that demon that was in the cutscene. That big, ugly one. No. That was a Cerberus. I want a Cerberus. I love Cerberuses. That thing is huge. Oh, damn. It's really cool to see that action being played out in a CGI movie. Mainly because it looks cooler in the movie. Oh God. The music's beautiful. Why does it keep fading in and out? Is that the Marshal? He looks like the Marshal. Doesn't sound like him, but he looks like him. He looks just as untrustworthy as he does in the game. Wait, so wait. Arden is the reason why they're to be wed? Is that what I got from that? That's what it seemed like. Seemed like it was his idea, like that he wanted them to get married. Oh, that's my jam. He's got a point. Yeah, that's what I got from when Arden said that. It's like it's either he knew they were to be wed, or he wants them to be wed. They look like a biker gang. I wonder what's so special about her mission. God, I'm so hungry. Oh. She's going to get Princess Lunafreya. Okay, I had to get my drink. So extremely sorry for all those noises. Okay, so I was right. Arden, that is a deal. What? So that makes me not really. Wow. That was her mother that got killed. and the kid that was the guy that was screaming for him, I'm presuming that was her brother. I mean, I understand, you know, because Knox does show that he does love her, and that I can't really tell if she loves him. She's very fond of him, I can tell from the games. But now that I know that the wedding is only orchestrated by the Imperials, I don't care about the wedding at all. Then again, I didn't care about it in general. But now knowing about now knowing the truth behind it, it's just like, eh, what the hell? No, wait. The kid screaming out for Regis couldn't have been the brother. One, because he was a little older, and two, he saw the Imperials or Niflheim kill their mother. And you can tell from Luna's brother that he doesn't believe Luna when she says that. Oh, that's the regalia. What kind of fucking voice is that?
For some reason, that gave me shivers. Ooh. I was just about to say. I was just about to say. I was like, wait, she was supposed to go for Luna Freya. Wasn't she? Oh, God. No, wait, no, she wasn't supposed to go to Luna Freya, I think. I don't remember if she gave the I don't remember if she did give the box to him with the hair clip. I don't remember that now. But when the flies went off, I was like, wait, there has to be a reason for that. Okay, so she was supposed to be with Luna, an escort. I feel bad for him though. I mean, I knew something bad would have happened to her, but I didn't think it would go to the point of killing her. I mean, that cartoon that happened right afterwards was kind of a hint that something, not kind of a hint, but it was a hint to say, you know, something bad is going to happen to her. He really cared about her. So she did give it to them. I'm sorry, just I have a bad memory at times. I don't get it then. Oh wait, no, I get it. I completely forgot that by the time some of the stuff is already going on, Noctis is doing everything in chapter one. Like in the back of my mind, I was just thinking to myself, so wait, he sent Noctis away, but the attack hasn't happened yet, and I forgot the attack happened during chapter two. You know, that part of his cape or whatever it is kind of makes it look like Arden has like a fallen wing. Like a fallen angel or something. Okay, so she did have it. God, I have the worst attention span and the worst memory. I didn't even realize it was going through the box. I thought he probably went through the box already, so I didn't see him going through the box earlier. What the hell? If I remember right, that looks like the knight that attacked Regis. Why the hell are they sending a military? That's that same guard that was messing with them. I wonder if Arden is with him. Yeah, of course he is. I think King Regis might have already known it. I guess he didn't. I guess he wasn't suspicious of it. To me, in my mind, I always thought Regis was suspicious of it and accepted his fate. I mean that, you know, because he said knock this away. I never noticed that, but I was like, oh wait, no, I remember it. It's been so long since I saw the beginning of the game, I completely forgot about it. That he did have trouble walking down the steps. God damn. Sad thing is, I think I did see the princess in the cars when they were going to the ceremony. So all it was a distraction. Get the glaive away from the ceremony so that way they have free time. Oh. Oh. Damn. Huh, apparently she was with him. I thought I saw her in the car. What is he talking about? I was expecting, like, Luna Freya was just a ploy. Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck is that? So it was all a ploy. Get the glaive away, and the Niflheim will play. And there goes the shield. So many traitors. What the hell is that? Looks like something from Dead Space. I understand they're robots, but that was still funny. You just keep, ooh. And there's the general. Too much of a coward to hide behind a mask or armor in general. Damn. You know, I would have really loved to fight this guy. Oh. Oh. Luna Freya is a crazy bitch. But I have a feeling I know why she needs to see King Regis as soon as possible. It's the ring. Because she does have the ring in the game, but she doesn't have it here. Ooh. Did he cut off his hand? Ooh. I don't think I've ever noticed his arm damaged at all. He's doing the same thing as her. This general is kind of a badass. Well, at least he has manners. He at least bows down to a king before he slays him. Looks like he just cut off a finger. A couple fingers. Because I can see some of the blood. I will say this movie keeps throwing me for a loop. At one point, I'm like, you know, I had a feeling Regis knew the attack was coming, so that's why he sent Noctis away. You know, I figured that when I was playing the game and watch this movie, and it kind of comes off like he doesn't know it's coming. That's a big statue. He must be kicking himself real hard. Now the king's gone, the magic isn't. The magic doesn't work. Oh, fuck. You know, it's kind of awesome, to be honest. The fact that he has to, now he doesn't have the magic anymore. That he now has to rely on just skill like physical skill to win. What is he doing?
Thank you.
That kind of looks like the area where who's that? Ah, it's him. What the hell is his name? It's from Kingdom Hearts 2. He's gonna try it on, isn't he? What the fuck? What? What? The captain of the glaive? That's fucked up. I was wondering why he went after him, like why he ran him over. I'm like, wait, I thought he was gonna go back with the glaive. And then he runs him over, and it turns out. Oh my God, that blew me out of the water. I did not expect that. Is that Regis? So I wonder what happened to him, because you don't see him anywhere else in the game. I'm talking about
Oh, I had to stretch. Because I know Nyx is going to die. And there's the ugly beast. Oh shit. Huh. That's just beautiful to look at. He kind of looks like that samurai that keeps pissing me off and kicking my ass. Hoo-hoo. It's starting to kill him. Oh, shit. He broke the fucking sword. Did his arm just blow off? Oh, no, it didn't. Ah, that's why he's not around. Don't pray that. Don't pray that, because you're basically hoping he dies. And that is it for Kingsglaive Final Fantasy 15, the movie. What did I think about the movie? Personally, I really enjoyed it. I love the voice acting. I love the music. I love the CGI that was used in this movie. Though, this movie really didn't give me any reason to care about Lunafreya any more than, the game has. Which, with the game, I really haven't cared much about Lunafreya. And to be fair, even though I do think it's a good movie, some people are mixed on it. Not some people, but people are mixed on this movie. Some people hate it, some people love it. While I do think it's a good movie, I don't really think it's needed to, you don't need, I don't think you need to watch it. To have everything make sense to you in the game, there's like very little things that help answer certain things in the game, but it doesn't make it. You could pretty much look it up because it's like a really quick search, and it just there are very little things that explain certain things in the game, and I don't really think watching this movie for that is worth it. So, yeah, I would personally give this movie a 8 out of 10 at least. So let's see. I'm gonna be fast forwarding it now because I know there's a scene at the end, which is at 1:54:59, 1 minute, 1 hour 54 minutes and 59 seconds. Now, this scene I actually have seen. Which it does show the conversation, like what they were talking about before the beginning of the game. Which I think was pretty cool. So, yeah, that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys again next time. And I do plan on doing an audio commentary on the anime. Final Fantasy 15 Brotherhood.